Hey everybody, Kiru Paul here. Welcome to the channel. A few days ago, on October 13th, 2021, the U.S. Embassy in Mexico released a message to U.S. citizens and entitled this thing Immigration Enforcement. Well, this little message has generated quite a buzz on social media. It's got people asking things like, has Mexico suddenly become really strict about immigration and cracking down on immigration violations? Before we get into that, here's the message from the embassy, in case you missed it. U.S. citizens are reminded that if you enter Mexico by land and plan to travel beyond the immediate border area, you must stop at a National Migration Institute, INM office, to obtain an entry permit, a Forma Migratoria Múltiple, or FMM, even if not explicitly directed to do so by Mexican officials. When traveling in Mexico, the law requires that foreign visitors carry a passport and entry permit. You may be asked to present these documents at any point. If you do not present these documents, immigration authorities may lawfully detain you for up to 60 days while they review your immigration status. Well, that sounds pretty scary, doesn't it? Immigration checkpoints are common in the interior of Mexico, including in popular tourist areas far from the border. They are. There's a lot of them around. U.S. citizen residents in Mexico should carry their resident identification cards at all times. It goes on to actions to take. Obtain entry permit FMM at an INM office if entering Mexico through a land border and traveling beyond the immediate border area. For you folks who fly into Mexico, you're going to be given that FMM at the airport when you pass through immigration. So number two on the list, carry your passport and entry permit FMM with you. For U.S. citizens who reside in Mexico, carry your resident identification card. So that's what's got everybody talking and asking that question. Has Mexico suddenly gotten very strict when it comes to enforcing its immigration laws? No. They've always been very strict. I'll give you an example. Linda and I moved to Mexico in 2015. And that year alone, Mexican immigration authorities sent 181,163 people back to their countries of origin. Those stats come right from the immigration folks themselves, or the Instituto Nacional de Migración, or INM for short. You saw INM was mentioned also in that little message from the U.S. Embassy. Well, 181,000 people is a lot of people, right? Admittedly, that was a big year for immigration authorities in Mexico. The years since then, the numbers have been lower, but still substantial. The majority of the people sent back to their countries of origin each year are from Central America, with only a very small percentage being from the US or Canada. I say that because the majority of the people watching my channel are from the US or Canada. In 2015, out of that 181,163 people, only 2,282 of them were from the US and only 13 from Canada. Apparently, you Canadians do not get in trouble very often, do you? As I said, Mexico has always been strict about immigration enforcement. Lynn and I have actually been stopped twice by immigration authorities at checkpoints far from the border since we moved to Mexico. And the last time was a few years ago. It wasn't even recent. Both times we were released right after we showed proof that we were legally in the country. The second time I got stopped, I asked the immigration agent why we were stopped. And he told me, well, you do not appear to be Mexican. He then went on to tell me that they, meaning the immigration folks, work checkpoints like that one about once a week in that area for 4 hours or until they fill the two caged immigration detention vans that were parked in front of me. Now, I could see heads inside those vans. That's how strict they are in Mexico. And remember, this was a few years ago. So don't freak out when you hear about immigration officials checking documents around the country at checkpoints, etc. That's nothing new. What is new this year is that Mexico has been dealing with a tremendous influx of immigrants entering the country in caravans from the south en route to the U.S. And this has resulted in quite a few violent clashes between these caravan members and members of the National Guard. So, although immigration enforcement has always been high on the Mexican government's list of priorities, it has certainly moved up several notches this year. I'm a stat guy, so let's look at the stats so far this year. Well, according to INM, and those are the immigration folks in Mexico, remember? Well, they've only released stats from January to August of 2021, but up until that point, they had sent back 65,799 people back to their countries of origin. When you hear that number, it's important to keep in mind that that number does not include the people who are still in the system. We're talking about people who are detained in immigration facilities or those who are waiting for their cases to be heard. Since that little message from the U.S. Embassy inspired this video, I'll let you know how many of those 65,799 people were from the U.S. 451. That's it. Keep in mind that during that same period of time, millions of Americans entered Mexico. In fact, over 6 million by plane alone. Now, I haven't researched the backstories of those 451 folks that got sent back to the U.S. by Mexican immigration authorities, but I suspect that more than a few of those cases might have involved poor life choices. Oh, and you Canadians are still not getting into trouble. Only 5 of you were sent back from January to August of this year. As the U.S. Embassy pointed out in their message, immigration checkpoints are very common in the interior of Mexico. And what they didn't mention is that immigration works hand in hand with the National Guard to locate people who are unlawfully in the country. So both INM agents and National Guard members may ask you for that documentation to prove your legal presence in Mexico. That's why it's always important to make sure you follow the advice of the U.S. Embassy and carry your original documents with you. And if you can't carry those documents for some reason, because let's say that day you're going to go to the beach or something and you don't want to leave your passport laying up there in the sand, at least have clear photos on your phone of all the necessary documents. Just having photos on your phone is not an ideal situation, and it may not be accepted by the person inspecting your documents, but it may just help dispel any suspicion that the agents have that you're unlawful in the country. I can tell you that when we were stopped by immigration a few years back and we were on our way to the grocery store, the agent said photos would suffice for routine checks like that one, but nowadays, I'm hearing that people are being asked for original documents. The reason is that they can check the security features in those documents to make sure they're not fraudulent. You can't do that as easily with a photo, and you definitely can't do it with a photocopy. Still, something is better than nothing, right? I plan to do a separate video about the legal requirements to carry immigration paperwork with you, and I'm going to go into a lot more detail. That video is going to be chock full of legal citations and will most likely contain a lot more detail than most people are looking for, but hey, that's just who I am, right? That's my style. If you don't want to miss that one, be sure to subscribe and hit the little bell so you'll get a notification when it comes out. Well, that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Until next time, hasta luego.